Hey, it's Mikey. Coming right up is a Beach Boys concert from May 29th, 2000 in Anderson, South Carolina. This was a free concert for everyone who had attended the festival that day, so it was a large, diverse crowd. This was the first concert that I'd seen of the Beach Boys without Carl, so I was a little sad about that, but the two guys who switched off doing Carl's guitar and vocal parts did a really great job. The band was excellent, and we all had a great time at the show. We hope you enjoyed as much as we enjoyed being there. Thank you for listening.
Southern California, America's band, the Beach Boys!
Release the Thank you. right, that's enough fast songs for this old group. So we're just going to do a Barry Manilow medley now, followed by, never mind, I don't think so.
Thank you, John.
Maybe not. I want to introduce you to a fellow who joined our group in 1965. The first song he sang with us was California Girls, not a bad start, I must say. And he's the only guy on stage here, in this band anyway, that has a Grammy for songwriting, Mr. Bruce Johnston, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Bruce joined our group to take the place of my genius cousin, Brian Wilson, who is not only a musical genius, he's a practical genius because he stayed home since 1965, and we've continued to send him money. That's pure genius. If you get that job, take it. All right, but then we had problems because Bruce's voice changed after a couple of years.
What do you mean?
we had to scour the planet to find an individual dedicated enough to go undergo the operation in order to permanently sing high this time. We found him in a pub outside of London, England, which is where he's from, Mr. Adrian Baker over there.
Thank you!
Oh, boy. Yes. All right, so we're going to dedicate this next one to all the lovely ladies here tonight.
Yeah.
Concert back in the other millennium, we would, about this time of our show, we would go into what we refer to as our automotive classics. We like to say automotive classics because it sounds so much nicer than used car songs, which is what they are. But since this is the year 2000, I don't think anybody wants to hear a song as old as Little Deuce Coupe anymore. Besides that, some of the younger folks out there think that 409 refers to the year that song came out, and that hurts. Then there's a little old lady from Pasadena. Not too much applause there, that was Jan and Dean. But at any rate, in the 60s we thought the little old lady was kind of old. In the 90s, in the year 2000, she's looking pretty good, actually. Right about now. Then there's the song Shutdown, but that's, we can't do that in front of the family here because, no. We don't want to steer the youth of our nation in the wrong direction. It's about two high-powered, gas-guzzling speeding cars actually drag racing and violating the law. Can you imagine singing a song like that? What's next? Gangster rap or something? So we don't want to influence the youth of our nation in a bad direction. We got President Clinton for that. We don't need to get involved. Then there's I Get Around. Oh, sure, in the 60s it was fun, but I don't know. I'll tell you what. Is there anybody out there, in spite of the vintage of these used car songs, that still want to hear the dumb, stupid car songs anyway? Is there somebody? Man. Shoot. I want to congratulate this audience for bringing, you kids, for bringing your grandparents to the show tonight. It's a really, it's good family values here. All right, good. Okay, let's hover the high rods one more time.
Yeah.
going to go back to the future now, musically speaking. We're going to go back to the time when we were sitting around the radio in Southern California, before we were known as the Beach Boys. One of the things we like to do is sing those doo-wop songs on those R&B radio stations. So we're going to do a classic doo-wop song, and then we're going to back up Mr. Adrian Baker with that fantastic rendition he does of our East Coast rivals back during the 60s, the Four Seasons classic Sherry. You won't believe that the way he does it. You won't believe it. Then we actually did record on the flip side, on the B side, on the back side, on the other side of the single record back in 1963, Fun. We actually did record the classic by Frankie Lyman and the No Longer Teenagers called Why Do Fools Fall in Love? We're gonna do that one. It's a really fun song to sing. Okay, now for those of you who don't have a clue of what I'm talking about, you don't even understand if I'm speaking in English or not, what I mean when I say single record, it was this thing about this big around. It was made out of a plastic product called vinyl, and it had a hole in the middle. Yeah, you've probably seen them in your grandparents' record collection, yes. Mm-hmm. And then what you would do with these things is you stack them on the record player. Now what a record player was, never mind, it gets complicated. Okay, well let's start off this little, retrospective, shall we say, with that doo-wop classic.
Come on.
Mr. Mike Kowalski. All right, a little more than two decades of tenure with the organization, the mystical, magical Maryland of music, Mr. Mike Merrows from Baltimore, Maryland, right there. A fantastic performer, as you can hear and see, plays and sings his buns off. That's true. Born in Jamaica, raised in Orange County, California, Mr. Philip Bardowell. Yes. All right. And from Livonia, Michigan, which is another way of saying Detroit. Anyway. He's our boss on the road, our musical director, Mr. Chris Farmer, ladies and gentlemen, right there. And our resident alien number two, number one, of course, being Mr. Baker from London, England, the motherland. Our other resident alien is our French-Canadian from Northern Ontario, Canada, Mr. Tim Bonnell. And now it's time to do a song from the Pet Sounds album. Bruce, you want to tell them about it?
I think this is the best song Brian Wilson ever wrote. And his brother Carl sang the song for many years, and unfortunately we lost him. He passed away a couple of years, and I'd like to dedicate God Only Knows from the Beach Boys to Carl Wilson. Here we go, guys.
Beach Boys musical career so far, anyway. 1966, Good Vibrations, not the number one. And then, just 22 short years later, Kokomo. That's correct. All right. Okay. So I'll tell you what. I don't know. I think we should have some sonic transportation back to those times before we do Good Vibrations, just to get everybody in the mood. This is our psychedelic song. How about some 60s sort of sonic transportation for us? Flashbacks up there.
Where I go.
Pet Sounds album. How about Snoop John B?
sing.
Everybody's gone surfing.
Surfing USA.
The Beach Boys version of a Beatles version of a Beach Boys song. If you can figure that out. It's called Back in the USSR and heard it first in India in 1968. Paul McCartney's acoustic guitar, and I suggested that he pack it up with all these girls from around Russia. I was trying to confine the Beatles to Russia. Didn't work, but you try these things. Anyway, so here's our version of their version of a Beach Boys song.
Bye.
dance, dance, baby.